What up, what up? Winbush here, and today I'm excited to take a look at the Intel's first generation GPU, which is the INTEL ARC A770. Now, this card came out around the end of last year, so it's about a year old now, but I wanted to put it through its paces since Intel did send it out to me, and I wanted to see if it could be used for 3D programs like Unreal Engine, Blender, Cinema 4D, Embergen, etc. And so this is considered a mid-level gaming card, even though this card packs 16 gigs of memory on it. I wanted to see how it adds up. So for the first example, I downloaded this scene. It's called Slay. You can get it right there on the marketplace. But if you look at my window here, you can actually see that I put it up to the epic settings there. And then once I turn on frame rate, I'm getting around 15 FPS. And this is just running inside the viewport. So you can see it's running a little bit slow there and a little bit choppy. But the thing is, whenever I went to go render this out, it actually rendered out at a pretty decent pace. I know somebody on Twitter was asking me to see it inside a movie render queue. And so I got it set up, I have it rendered, and this is what it looks like. So as you can see, once it's rendering out, it is going at a decent speed. If you want to see exactly how long this plays out, I'm not going to do that here. I'll put it at the end of the video just so you can see in real time how this actually renders out. But this is a look at the video as it's actually rendered out. It does look pretty good, so it is capable of being able to render out this particular scene out of Unreal Engine 5. Now, the next scene that I'm going to be looking at inside of Unreal Engine 5 is the one that came out a few years ago that was made by Weta. This is when they added the fur inside of Unreal, and this was the showpiece that they used. So the big caveat I saw is whenever I put it on the higher settings, I'm starting to get this really green fuzz in there. Even when I tried to render it out, I was getting that same green fuzz. And so I had to bring it down to a lower setting just to get it to look right inside of the viewport. And once you play it back, it actually plays pretty good. So if you look right here, you can see it's actually playing back at around 50 frames per second there. I'm going to put it on full screen. You can see that we have the ferret. I think it's a ferret there, but everything looks good. This is running real time inside the viewport, not rendered out at all. And we're getting a solid 45 to 50 frames per second there. So I'd have to say for this specific one, I'm actually impressed at how it's playing back inside the viewport. But when I went to render it out, I was getting that green fuzz on there, and I'm not sure exactly what's going on with that. And so for this particular scene, I was not able to get it rendered out, but it did play back inside the viewport. And so for this next example, I'm staying inside of Unreal Engine 5. I'm actually going to attempt to run the Electric James demo that came out earlier this year during GDC. This is the one that showcases the PCG inside of Unreal, and it's pretty intense. So if I'm looking at the screen here, you can actually see that it has the recommended specs here. I'm actually just going to run through the animation aspect of it. I'm not going to navigate around the scene. As you can see, I'm getting around 5 to 6 frames per second, which, I mean, for as big and as intensive as this scene is, I'm not surprised at all. We're getting some flickering in there, in which I think that's happening from the texture streaming, but it's able to showcase it at least at full res there. We're not getting really good frame rates. We're getting some flickers in there, but let's go on and see how it looks with some of the other animations. So this is the one that's pulling up above. We're seeing all the foliage there. We're seeing some of the cliffs. We're still getting around 6 frames per second on there. And again, this is all running inside the viewport. This isn't rendered or anything. So this is just the feedback that you would get as you're trying to navigate inside of Unreal Engine 5 there. And then for the last Unreal test, I'm just going to put in a VDB into the scene and just see how the playback is. So look inside the scene here. I have the tornado. This comes from Embergen. And you can see just running a simple VDB in here, we're getting around 70, 75 frames per second. Just have it running on loop. Let's actually put this up to cinematic and see what we get here. So we get a dip a little bit inside the frame rate. We're getting around 50 frames per second, which isn't bad. I mean, this is just one VDB playing back in here, but we're able to get playback in here. And so for my final assessment, I would say if you did have this graphics card, you are capable of running Unreal Engine. No, it's not the most powerful card, but if you're on a budget and you need something, it might suffice, but there are other options out there. As I was saying, this isn't optimized for Unreal, at least to my knowledge, like the NVIDIA and AMD cards are. And so I would say go in there at your own risk. So speaking of Embergen, I actually wanted to try out Embergen since it is GPU intensive and see how that works. So I installed Embergen, I went to get it to work, and this is what popped up. And so I have this error here that says integrated graphics card detected. We have detected that you're using an Intel integrated graphics card, and it's just giving me that error there, or at least a warning. And so as I started to run up Embergen, just give us a few moments to get loaded up and let's see what we're gonna have happen. So this is what keeps happening here. I keep getting the fatal error, and I'm thinking it's basically because this isn't using CUDA cores. I think Embergen might be based off of CUDA. I'm not sure, I never tried it on an AMD card, but I keep getting that error whenever I pop it up. And so I'm not able to run the test using Embergen with this specific card. But I did still wanna see how we could get some type of pyrotechnics working on this card. And so I opted going to Cinema 4D 2024. So after I hit play, it took a few moments there to get loaded up. But once it did, it's actually playing back inside the viewport. And so at least this works there. We know if we have an Intel card and we're trying to use Cinema 4D, at least this type of stuff that is GPU intensive is gonna work. But let's go ahead and check out Redshift. I know Redshift works with NVIDIA, it works with AMD. I'm not sure if it's gonna work with Intel or not. So let's actually go in and see what kind of settings we can set up with this. So I'm gonna come up here, hit render settings. We're gonna see what we could do. We see we have a render setup for Redshift. So if I come over to edit, come down to preferences, and then let's go down there into render. And now we're going to click on Redshift and let's see what we have. So if I look at system, you can see that I have my CPU in there, which is a Threadripper 3, but it doesn't have listed the GPU. And so this is what I was expecting. You know, with Redshift, they usually optimize it for the specific graphics cards, as I was saying, mostly with NVIDIA and most recently with AMD. And so it might take a little bit for them to get into Intel since this is the first generation card. And so if you're a Redshift user, I probably would stay away from this card. So with Blender opened up right now, I actually have the preferences open because I wanted to see if it's going to work with cycles. I have a device on GPU and it looks like it's not particularly working in there, even though it recognizes the Intel card in there. So let's actually put it on Eevee and see what kind of results we get with that, since Eevee actually uses the GPU exclusively. So once I have it on Eevee, you can see that we now have the scene inside of Blender here. And let's actually go through and play it and see how it's going to play back here. So as you can see, it actually plays back inside the viewport. I could come up, let's render out a frame. Only took 1 second to render out that frame there. So it actually does work with Eevee. And so, you know, I'm running this card through its paces, but this is more geared towards a gaming card. Like this is considered like a mid-level gaming card. So just for fun, I ran it with Fortnite. It looks like even with the high settings there, like I put it on auto and I was able to get what it thought the card would be good for. And I'm still getting 60 frames per second there inside of Fortnite. And then I ran it with Control as well, because Control is ray tracing enabled there on the PC. And it looks like it's running pretty well with Control there as well. So for a gaming card, like if you are a gamer, I know there's better reviews out there for people that specifically look at this stuff for gaming. It's a pretty good gaming card, but for 3D professionals, I haven't seen any reviews out there. So that's why I put this video together. And I just wanted to see if this would actually work for us. And so in conclusion, I would say maybe wait for a pro card. I think they're working on like a pro series card. Maybe that would be something that's more in depth to us. And again, this is first generation, so a lot of programs, they're not optimized for the Intel cards yet. But if Intel keeps up with it, maybe they have a player at their hands, I would say the more the merrier, because right now you mostly have NVIDIA. Like, yeah, you have AMD in there as well, but I would say for the most part, most people use NVIDIA for professional use. And so it's always good to have other players in there as well. And so as I was promising, if you wanted to check out the Slay rendering in real time, I'm going to put that up right now. But this is the end of the video. So if you like videos like this, make sure you leave me a comment down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. And until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.